Hello, hi, I am Spanter Fiorose, but you can call me Span. How are you? How are you? Today, I am in the big wide world of outdoors. Ta-da! I'm at the park. I'm sitting in the shade. I hope that the muffler is working. Because there's a little slight breeze. Over here you might be able to see there's a really nice fountain, and from where I'm sitting occasionally I can see the ducks with the ducklings walking around, which is just so lovely. There is, however, the inescapable sound of construction work in the background, and that lift, it's just, I'm acutely in tune with it. It just, my sensitivities are very sensitive to those particular sounds, so even when I walk 2 blocks away, I can still hear them, and they're still disturbing me. However, hopefully that doesn't pertain to you in any way. Just nice background ambience. So I had to get out of the house today, my new house, because I put the washing machine on, and again, I cannot deal with the screaming. So I've had a couple of hours to spare, and I didn't want to go to the shops because I've already did that yesterday and gave myself a headache and spent too much money, and yeah. So we've come to sit in the park, and I thought we could do some silent reading. I'll try and protect you a little bit. The wind seems to be coming from that way, seems to be coming from that direction. So I'll try and set you in a position where that won't bother you too much. But yeah, I just thought it would be really nice to come and chill for a couple of hours in the great outdoors. I was going to be like, get some sunshine, which I am doing. See, there it is. This is the sunshine. This is the sunshine I'm getting. Here it is. But it's actually very hot, and I am not very good at dealing with the heat. So it's only like 24 degrees, but still, that's just hot enough for me. Any more than that, I'm like no-go zone. So we'll see how I go in Queensland in January. Anyway, that is a story for another day. I hope you're doing well, and this is just a very long intro to a silent reading video, so let's get on to that. Let's see if I can get you to stand up on your own. There's a burp. I don't know if you can see him. He's very cute anyway. Alright. Hopefully that's not too wobbly or too windy. So a book that I have with me today is The Lost Apothecary, which my friend Chrissy has lent to me. So that's what I'm going to be reading. That's all. It's started off a bit slow, and I was like, I don't really like the way this is written. I'm not sure about this. And then I'm now on page 71, and I got past like page 50, and I was like, I got to make it to at least the end to give it a chance. And I was like, okay, I'm hooked. So yeah, I'll be reading that now. But also something could be the most dimension of the pocket through the upper end of the pocket through some friend of Burbs, the pocket through is a common man among them, death's like a serial killer, and there'll be side both closer, side both the sheets closer, except for the night again, unread messages, but I'm not email. Email, inbox, first aid, coming out of the kingdom, barely in London, and the first London incident, there was a result replayed, there was indeed a bear alley in London, a man under the plane that was close, very close to me. Same barely. risk I'm willing to take. That was pretty decent. Like, really decent, actually. There's a frisbee. Frisbee golf course right near me, so I have just sat in front of one of them, which I realize now is probably a bad mistake, but we'll see how loud the clanging is, I guess. It's so embarrassing up close, but not far away. That's interesting. Maybe because they can see what I'm doing. Oh well, stay strong. I'd just like to come attempt my clean idea about what I can have himself what I knew better later. I'll just better than back to the wall, which was assembled to release eggs. So it was a set of fence love incident so much that I'd left my bumps against the wall to bounce myself and not forget what I'd done. And then the second comes to ammo quickly, and then I left for a good one by the idea of another voice calling my name through the walls and burned myself as written spread for the release in the spread. She had such a stupid position. She left it. Did you? wasn't so random disruptive points because the walls around it is. Heck, this building even existed. Looking for a lost cat. Can't ask if I swim behind me. I took my hand for the conductor to open up 15 feet of my mind. And again, his pets and a matching shed stood watching me and amused looking at his pets' instruction. What could possibly be scared like a deck of sorry, I didn't mean to leave. That sorry to step in feeling ridiculous. What good reason could I possibly be better? But as compared with my husband, it's just around the corner. I let him in front of me in front of this old gate. It's such a good looking picture. I'm going to go. Don't let me stop you. That creepy place for a picture, though, if you ask me, he's naked. Taking full from his dress, I appreciate that he kept his head different ways so constant with photos around me. Yeah, because it is crazy and I do with the clearing. He says he'd have no idea if he is back. By our gun and tried to set up shop, it would have been perfect, but he said that they couldn't get permits. It's hard to see from here, but there's actually a service door over there. But it leads to a sub cellar or something. Guess the folks behind the building want to keep this area clear. I guess they would need to get in there. But it was suddenly, that's me. It's good to go. I'm buzzing no sudden again from his pocket through the small pocket. Well, thanks for the info. I said, no worries. Back to the cage. He said, I'll put this one to the pillar. I pulled myself up with a few better look over it. I just stepped immediately into the clearing where the bomb up and pointed from this vantage point. I squatted doing another man. Then he spread one drop. I made out of a bit to be a large piece of wood. Instead of a rusty door, I look at this little stone pillar. I was almost definitely a door, but it was just coming open in a very, very long time. Now, I opened the door to the woman who saw her. I've been retreating to the shadows of the pillar. So I went, and I think it went behind as she fell. What am I going to let them with the first skirts and the delicate? Then she took a hesitant forward, but a bright floating behind her and again a little illuminated before my comforting grasp was seen as she put up a full-strength gossip like I did with my shop. At first, I'd seen a bit tall, but now it was a grand woman and by mere prince seemed impossible to do the air paths and gangs into the water. Again, a deep green and a gold and embroidered lily seemed to be able to absorb the space. I did a single turn maze in my vowels to the floor. The woman removed her vowels and closed them with the dip. Taking bubbles of pink lily to dry them by the fire, the gesture was so obvious. It was gone now. It's so dark in here, she said. Her conchial painted lips turned down what I will add more fire to the fire jump to Liza. Apparently, my second time in my shop, but in some way she began to outwit me. Sit, please, please, sit, my lady, please. I said, motioning to the chair. She lowered off delicately onto it, and without a long, shaky breath, she removed a hairpin from the back of her head and just took off clothes and ripped them into place. Eliza stepped forward with the mug on her hands, setting it carefully at the table before the woman. Warm peppermint water, miss, she said, curtsying. I looked and given her. Thank you for the invitation in your letter, I said to the woman. She raised her eyebrow. I didn't know how much to say. I looked a great length to protect myself from the event I was seized. And another reason, it didn't matter what the rich people always wanted, what they have, their secrets most of all. You just said enough, and I believe we'll be pleased with the preparation. Screeching sound interrupted as I turned to see Eliza dragging a wooden box across there. She perched upon it at the table between the woman and myself, followed her into it. I'm Eliza. We're so pleased to have you here. Thank you, the woman replied, her eyes opening as she took another go. And I made my way up here today, and I realized that would be too obvious. She looked at me expectantly. Your daughter, I wish my daughter were by my side, but then we would have been doing all this at the Spitzing Presents, and I've she helps me on occasion. I lied, unwilling to help. Then Eliza had arrived without notice at the perfectly wrong time. There was no two chairs on the table for a reason. I only was in the room betting pitiless that I noticed the lifetime failing discretion. So clearly I had the mistake in allowing Eliza to encroach on the secrets of my brother's woman and myself. You leave her first now. No, the woman said with the force of someone while the custom was getting her away. This peppermint tea is very good. You got it, so I'm more like, and I'd seem like more brass hats in the presence of a child to be comforting. I don't have to do my own, you know, as bad as I said about them, but very much we've never mind that. How old are you, little Eliza? Where are you from? I could only believe this woman to the heiress to some greatest common with me. The weather did this way, my belly's the little pigs in a way. How lucky she was to have the time to not yet passed. The skin around her eyes told me that you'd be more than 30 years old. It was not too late for 12, Eliza said softly. I'm from Swindon. The woman went not too brief. Sometimes I see ghosts out of the corner of my eye. I will finish this page and then I should probably